Hey guys, it's your boy Rivers, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Liverpool promo where last time I thought I beat Swansea in the league, and I won my fourth group stage match in the Champions League, which means I am now guaranteed to be going through, which means I can simulate the last two group stage matches without worry that I might lose my voice. The worst happens. But that's not the concern of this episode. The concern of this episode is two league matches against Newcastle United and Southampton. First up is the Geordies. He's at St. James's. Let's do this.
Hi there, everybody. Alan Smith alongside me, Martin Tyler. In the commentary box, it's with great view up here, Alan, and a great game, I think, in prospect.
And Newcastle gets in their way.
Looking forward to an entertaining match here.
And they do.
Interesting team, this, for Newcastle United. Several changes. Tim Krul starts in goal. Musa Sissoko starts. He's got his shot off now.
Oof. With my defense almost falling over each other, for Newcastle, I had a very good start to take a shocking lead.
Managers like players get called up by international set.
Yes, be on my toes.
Well, I think he does deserve a chance. I think.
Speaking of Newcastle, well, they've finally confirmed that they will be managed by Rafa Benitez next season. I can definitely see him getting them straight back up as Neymar puts them down. Ha! But yeah, I can definitely see him getting them straight back up, especially if he's been given full power over transfers, as it was reports he wanted.
Johan Gufra.
We have a lot of managerial changes. Darby have a new manager, Mr. Ostrich himself, Nigel Pearson. Yes, he's back. So, am I the only one hoping Darby and Leicester meet somehow next season? Because that would be brilliant.
Only just missed it.
Just having Nigel Pearson back is the name. I'm going to be watching a lot more championship next season because the dude is hilarious. And he's not the only one who's back. Yes, I'm sure you've heard the special one is back. And he's at Manchester United because of course he is.
Ronaldo, great contact.
Obviously Manchester United weren't paying attention to anyone to Chelsea this past season, because if they had, they'd know Mourinho just got sacked because Chelsea were terrible. So expect Mourinho to lose a lot of games, fire Man United's doctor, and eventually get sacked. Or call them small horses, either way. That's what Man United can look forward to, not a challenge for the title.
Big ask for the manager and the players, because this is an awful luck that they've got into. They've got to dig themselves out of the hole that is five consecutive defeats.
Yeah. Of course, this is also the incoming Pep Guardiola. I don't know if Watford have found a new manager yet, because of course
first touch was poor.
The manager left at the end of last season. And Everton too, they're still looking for a new manager, so There'll be a few new managers in the Premier League next season.
The ball on that occasion. He wants it returned, and it's returned to him.
And as I was saying, back to Newcastle for a second. As you guys know, well, how can you not, unless you don't follow the Premier League? Maybe you don't. Not everyone does. But if you do follow the Premier League, you'll know that Newcastle got relegated. But there's some... But... If Newcastle were paying attention to the playoff final, then they would have gotten a bit of a pep-up. Because the winner of the Championship final, and the third being promoted to the Premier League, ironically taking Newcastle's spot technically, if you look at it this that way, is the return of Hull. So yeah, Hull are back straight away, which is what Newcastle will be looking to do next season. Come back straight away. Well, I'm sure the Newcastle fans would much rather do it automatically than be in the playoffs. But I'm sure if they have to go through the playoffs is to get up, if it's their last option, I'm sure they won't mind. Plus, it's the Mac is, I don't know if you get promoted, so.
Chancellor Mbemba.
I mean, if you do go through the playoffs, there's a bonus. So it's not all bad news for Newcastle. Raptonitas, I definitely think, I'd be shocked if Newcastle don't come up automatically next season.
Nathaniel Clyne. Jack Colback.
Although there will be other teams fighting for promotion, like Derby,
challenge between the two,
and Brighton, of course, who missed out folks this season. No doubt that they will want to come back stronger, as will any other team who participate in the championship next season.
The break is definitely on. Coming up now, a corner.
How did you miss that, Neymar? Yeah, I took a deflection, but still, how did you miss that?
Coming up for you, of course, on EA Sports, the presentation.
Huh. It's not ironic. Look at who Newcastle's next game is. It's Hull.
A lot of people have been talking about this one. Looking
forward. Talk about irony.
The way to win the ball back. He's fouled by Ronaldo.
And that's not the only foul that has taken place between now and the last time I talked to you guys. There's also the small matter of the Champions League final that took place last night, which of course was won by Real Madrid, because of course it was. And wouldn't you know it, Cristiano Ronaldo scored the winning penalty, because his Real Madrid got to kiss that Ronaldo ass. Seriously, they pandered to Cristiano Ronaldo for some.
In the next match in the Barclays Premier League, and I can only see one winner.
I get it. He's your best player. The man has a big enough ego as is. You don't need to make it bigger.
I'll be hoping it'll be effective. Alan McAnally back at Villa Park. He's got some news for us.
It's a third goal for Manchester City. It's been scored by Jesus Navas. He played a lovely 1-2, receiving the ball just outside the penalty area.
That's what I have to say about that.
73 minutes played. 3-1.
Is there anything else?
Thank you.
no real eye-opening transfers have happened in the past couple of days.
Not quite.
Really, that's pretty much it. It's a few managerial appointments and re-signing or reassuring that you're gonna stay. Here are just managerial updates in general, and two big finals. Of course, there's two more playoff finals to go. The League One final, which is today, and the League Two final, which is tomorrow. Why the championship final was first, I don't know. Ooh, normally it's League Two. Normally League Two is first, and then League One. Then the championship is on Monday. Why it's the other way around this year, I don't know, but hey. Found out sooner who the final team in next year's Premier League is going to be.
And Ronaldo. And the tackler.
Fixtures will be announced next month.
He's gone in strongly and got the ball. Fine save he's made there.
And there's the full-time whistle.
I talked through the whole goddamn match. Jesus Christ.
1-0. Could've done better. This. Them the breaks, I guess. Them the breaks. See, I'm gonna remove Gomez because. Yeah. Train someone else up. Brito is almost to 60. No, 70. I thought he was at 68 or something. So. No, he's higher than that. Sanchez and Perez. That right back. Both went up 70. 2 for Sanchez, 65 for the right back. Cool. Piss off. I don't need your updates. Stop giving them to me. No, absolutely not. Another transition? I had one, didn't I? Oh, it's an international break. That would explain it. Costa or Pullet? I think Costa's just slightly ahead. I'll do Costa and then when someone goes up, Brito should go up. He might go up in this one? Which would allow me to put Pullet in for next time, if he does. He did as well. 70 rated now is Brito. Which is... Nito. Yeah, I won't do that again. Can't afford to drop any more points, and I've already dropped enough. I was with the main squad, so yeah.
Plus, I'm not gonna disrespect Southampton like that. They deserve to face the best I can put out.
Hi there, everybody. Martin Tyler here. As the sign says, this is Anfield. And as
you expect, alongside
me, this is Alan Smith. This is the Liverpool side. Nathaniel
Bale
starts with Ricardo Rodriguez in fullback positions.
Get a nice early goal to start off this match. Still going. So I don't end up with another 1-0. I'll take it. A 1-0, but you know. More exciting. Then you score more goals, you know?
Today for the home side is incredibly a seventh
Bale.
Fantastic form for men.
No,
they will be full of confidence.
Safety first there.
The real Ronaldo would have scored that.
Robust start to the game. It's certainly a foul.
He was shot at.
He's got his cards in his pocket. That's going to run on through.
Hey, that's on target. Thanks, Foster, you idiot. Hello, what's
that?
He was probably gonna hit the post or something. I don't think it was going in. I mean, put on! Oh, Klein, how close! The right back. Oh, how unlucky. Against his former club as well. Pretty much the only Southampton player I have left in the team. The rest are all gone. I said this a while back, and I'll say it again. And with all the players we signed from Southampton, one of them was bound to be not utter shit. And thankfully, it was a defensive player. I mean, he couldn't fix our useless defense, but, you know, we can build on it. He can be the foundation of our defense.
That's broken up by the defender.
Yes, dirty center back.
Liverpool take over.
Left back who isn't completely brain dead. And now we'll be good. Get away from them. I can see a corner. It's okay. Nothing will come from. I have all my bases. Oh shit! Ooh! See? I was right. Now I can counterattack. If I had more than one person in support. To the man! I should have passed it. I don't know why I'm only figuring this out now.
Jordy Classic. Brilliant team play this, with the passing, the movement off the ball to make the passing possible.
Go Ronaldo, come on. There we go. Oh, that's more like it. 1-0. And it is Mr. Ronaldo who scores. I think it was actually an assist from Nathaniel Klein as well.
So the first goal, it's 1-0.
Former Southampton man sets up the former Real Madrid and Manchester United man. And it's 1-0.
Opportunity now!
Oh! Oh shit! Shit, shit, shit! Varane! What are you doing? Oh, Varane, you prick! What the hell are you doing? That would have been a lovely assist, you dumb mass.
Well, no scraps for the attackers to feed on from the goal.
Foul.
Hung on to the ball well.
Fuck hell. Just kick the ball out.
It's looking quite good for Liverpool, but only quite good. They would have hoped to be in a stronger position, but it could be worse, of course.
Ronaldo!
Towards the clock and half-time approaching.
Navas.
He's got that through clever reading of the game, intercepting and getting possession back to his team.
Long. Come on, Bale. Yes. Ronaldo.
And that's half time.
No, I wasn't on an attack, actually. Hey, referee, we were all hallucinating that, you prick.
Can Liverpool replicate a good first half in the second period, which is now underway?
Over the top. That makes up for the shot I would have had. If the fucker hadn't been an idiot and not followed the goddamn rules.
It's a real tussle between the two of them.
And get up and go back to defense, please.
Coutinho.
To the man's. Yes, great. Avoiding of the challenge. Ronaldo, how? Where is the logic? Win the corner. Ah, you son of a bitch, Bale.
On EA Sports very soon for you. The Champions Cup fixture.
Yeah, no one cares. I've already qualified.
Yeah, high quality fixture this one. There won't be much quarter given.
This bro.
To make an alteration here.
Finds no one but Timmermans, but I give it straight to Ward-Prowse. What the hell? What is wrong with everyone? Why can't anyone pass properly? For fuck's sake, Americ. If you're gonna be passing like that, Man City won't buy you at all.
Bale.
Oh my god. No one can pass, no one can defend, no one can keep the fucking ball, except the guys in the Southampton shirts! Glenn, can you put on your old Southampton shirt so you can get this kind of look? Please! So someone out here can do what I ask them to. Tillemans. Of course! Gives it straight to Classy.
And moving on, Alan.
Unless they're right in front of them. My players don't want to pass to the guys in red.
And he could get away here.
Oh my god, Gareth, for fuck's sake.
Just stopped in the nick of time.
I know they're your former team, but you're playing for Liverpool now. Don't do an Alberto Moreno on me, you cunt.
Cut out the pass. Intercepting if you like.
Really, Moreno? Really? You lost the ball. How did you lose the ball? You never lose the ball. Muscle the fucker onto the floor, run to goal, score. That's what Cristiano Ronaldo should do. That's what Cristiano Ronaldo always does. I've seen enough La Liga matches to know. Hell, I watched him in the Premier League. And that was before he did that more often. Get rid of it, Ricardo.
Good stop by the goalkeeper.
60%. Of course.
That'll be important, do you? Go on and push for another, or just try and...
Have you ever heard of playing the advantage referee? Oh my god. Oh my god. Do not.
Let them look like doing it.
Oh my god. Seriously? Seriously. Is this seriously fucking happening?
That's good defending.
Clear it. Thank you, Ricardo. Nothing they can do when the ball is at their...
Fantastic game, this. And it's going to go right down to the
line. Even if they have it. Come on, Cristiano. Thank you. That's more like it. That wraps up the 3 points. Finally.
And
What a finish this was. Really did put his boot through it to find the left-hand side.
Just widen the...
You're all incompetent today. Why, I don't know, but you are. Thank God that's over. Thank goodness. If I had to sit here any longer, I think I'd go absolutely insane. Get over it. I am not sure. Maybe I should have played you. Maybe then I would have had someone capable of putting two passes together. Instead of passing it straight to the opposition, which is the wrong thing to do. You know, don't mind me. I'm only their boss. You know, why should they listen to me? You know, that's retarded. Why would you listen to your manager? No, he can sell you. Never play you again. He has no power. For very much. In the next episode, when I play against Middlesbrough and Spurs, they better play better. Because every single one of them can be replaced. They better not even think that they can't be. Because I can make a motherfucking superstar out of anybody. And don't you fuckers forget it. There we go. Almost forgot. Can't send the second team in well with the main man in the defense. And he gets sent off again! For fuck's sake, Soul. I mean, it doesn't matter in the long run, I'm still gonna be going through, but still, what the hell was that? Yeah, just back from the suspension. Oh, you're suspended again. Really, that should be two games now, because that's your second red card. Wow, Seville did not go easy on Copenhagen. Have a look and see how that affects the table. Oof. Talk about cutting it close. I'm guaranteed to finish top no matter what. My last game is against Lille. Yep, sure is. It's actually the game after Spurs, so it'll be between the episodes. That episode, and the episode where I played West Brom and Man United.
So it's all going to come down to the last group game. I wonder who goes through with me and who is stuck with the Europa League. So, Ville must be massively conflicted. Yes, they're probably like, if we could go through, but we might get knocked out. And if we get knocked out of the group stage, we go into the Europa League, which we're guaranteed to win because we're Seville. Well, it's pretty much our bitch. Because they always seem to win it. Three in a row. Who's to say they won't make it four for next season? Who knows? All I know is that this is the end of the episode. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button if you did. And I didn't. And I'm glad this is over. Purely because I can't sit here and tolerate these idiots any longer. So thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. And until next time,